I'm going to hold this like this. It's no good way to hold a cucumber. Hello everyone, welcome to Big Friendly Grub. I hope you're safe and well. As you can see, I'm on my sofa today, so that probably means it's a food unboxing. And yeah, you're pretty much right, it is a food unboxing today. It's not like a taste test or anything like that. Today I'm going to be unboxing a box from Oddbox. This is Oddbox. It's not a very odd box, it's a odd box of fruit and veg, basically. Oddbox is a company which has been based in London mostly up until now. They are now starting to deliver to the Brighton Hove area. Oddbox is basically a box of fruit and veg that gets delivered to your door, which aren't quite the right shape and size to go into your supermarkets. There's a lot of regulations over what size and shape a piece of fruit and veg can be to make it onto the supermarket shelves. Basically, a load of stuff goes to waste. Oddbox are trying to eliminate that by basically taking all the stuff that wouldn't make it to you at the supermarket, putting it into a box and delivering it to you at a pretty reasonable cost. This one costs about $11.95, I think. This is a small box of fruit and veg, so you get a bit of a mix of both, and it's basically delivered to you once a week, or you can have it fortnightly, I think. I've gone for once a week. It will have a mix of stuff in it, and I thought today I would open one up, see what's inside it, and then from there I will try and make something using some of the bits and pieces that's in here, whether I use just one item or several items. I'm going to see what's in here. I have no idea. And then perhaps we can make something nice from it, because I think this is a good idea. The idea of cutting down on food waste is a really good idea to me. There's so much food waste out there. I hate food waste. If I try and make something and it goes wrong and I end up having to throw it away, it upsets me no end. I hate food waste. The fact that stuff goes to waste just because it's the wrong shape or size to go onto the supermarket shelves is a bit criminal to me. And I guess being a bit of an odd shape and size myself, I kind of relate to the fruit. You know, I've always been picked on a bit because I'm tall or a big bloke or things like that, and I guess I kind of relate to this, the little box of fruit here. So I thought I will delve in, have a look, see what's inside, and then we can have a go at making something using some of the stuff in here. So let's see what's inside. Let's see what fruit and veg has been brought to me today. So I'm going to open it up. I've already cut it open. Oh, I've got a bit of paraphernalia here from Oddbox. It's quite long. I won't read it all out. It's telling me basically what Oddbox is all about, and it's telling me what fruit and veg I'm rescuing this week, why it's being rescued, and what it works well for, where I should store it, and where it's come from as well. So that's actually pretty good. That's all on there. That's really nice. I really like that, actually. That actually tells you where it's come from. It's actually got a couple of recipes on here that you can use for some of this stuff as well. That's really good. Yeah, the fact that they've like bothered to kind of put what's in there, tell you where it's from, what you can use it for, and basically give you a couple of recipe ideas as well. But that's nice, that's really nice. How many times can I say nice? We'll see. It depends on what's in the box and see whether it's actually nice. So let's start off. I have got, oh, a romaine lettuce. I believe this is a romaine lettuce. Let me check the list. It is, it's a romaine lettuce. It's from Sussex and it's surplus apparently. Apparently it works well in a taco bowl. Yeah, I mean, taco bowl is one thing you could do with it. I mean, you know, lettuce is pretty versatile. You know, it's pretty much a good side for most things. Could use it for like a Caesar salad, going to a BLT, stuff it in a burger, whatever you want. It's always useful to have a lettuce. Then I have got here, I can see a lovely pair of pears, and these are, yeah, this is just a pair of pears. They are from South Africa and they were rescued because of their shape and skin marks, which, to be honest, I don't see anything wrong with these at all. You know, this is kind of like the pears I would probably end up seeing in the supermarket. Maybe they're slightly wonkier, but otherwise, these are two perfectly good pears. Sorry, three perfectly good pears that would go to waste otherwise. So what? Why do supermarkets feel that these aren't good for selling? I don't get it. Also in here, I've got three clementines. Have I got that right? Are these clementines? They are clementines. Good old, oh my darling clementine. These are also from South Africa and they've been cast off for their size, skin marks, and the fact that they were surplus as well. And again, I don't see anything wrong with these. There's a few marks around the side there that you might be able to see, but again, this is probably, you know, just wear and tear that these would end up getting picked up in the supermarket anyway. So again, this is perfectly good stuff that would go to waste. There's actually some more, a couple more clementines there. There's five clementines in there on the whole. Well, it's things I might find more as I dig through this box. Let's see what else I've got here. I've got a brown bag of mushrooms by looks things. Oh, that's a potato. Ah, mushroom away. I'm not going to pick up the whole bag because basically it's falling apart, but that's a really nice bag of mushrooms. And these are from the UK, the island, not the island. They're from Ireland and Poland. So they're a mix of places these have come from. Basically just surplus. What qualifies for surplus? How much surplus food can there be that was going to waste before they decide to like start putting it into boxes and things like that, and deciding to have like lines like the Morrison's Wonky Veg and stuff like that they can start selling. How much was going to waste before they started doing stuff like this? It boggles my mind. Right, also cucumber. Always good to have a cucumber around. I'm going to hold this like this because we had this before with, I think, the Morrison's food box. It's no good way to hold a cucumber. It says it's from the UK/Holland. I don't know how it can be from two places. Maybe it's from one or the other. So perhaps there's a various amount of places that they got these from. Apparently it's surplus as well. So I don't know what's going on there. Oh no, apparently it's shape, size and surplus. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. Again, does it have to be a certain length? What's wrong with that? Don't get it, but it's always good to have a cucumber around. I like using it for sandwiches. What else have we got in here? Oh, I've got a nice tub of blueberries. They're from Northamptonshire and they were just discarded because of their size. And again, I don't see anything wrong with those at all. These look like perfectly good blueberries to me. I do like a blueb. They are great for making things like sauces and things like that. I used some not very long ago for the vegan cheesecake, so you can use those for cheesecakes, desserts. Blueberries are great, they will come in very handy. Oh, I've got a couple of red peppers here. I can see these have probably been discarded because of their shape. This one is already quite wonky, but again, there's nothing wrong with that. They've been discarded because of their shape, size, skin marks, and their surplus as well. And these are from the UK, and they suggest using them for a chana masala, which is a nice idea. Good couple of peppers. I'm always using peppers. They're great for going in pretty much anything, or for stuffing as well. Not like the thing that you put in your roast, but like stuffing them with various things. Not couscous though, couscous is just disappointment. And then we have got some onions, just like four small size onions. They have probably been discarded because of their size. There's nothing wrong with these. I mean, you probably need like four of these for like one or two normal onions. But again, there's nothing wrong with them at all. They might have a slightly different flavor because of their size. But again, nothing wrong with these apart from their size. These will be very useful because I'm always using onions. Onions you just have to have all the time because they are the base of a lot of things. Then we have got a nice big, I think, Savoy cabbage, if I'm not wrong. I am not wrong, it is a Savoy cabbage. I do love cabbage, it is one of my favourite veg, especially a roast dinner. I just love cabbage with my roast. And this is one of my favourite cabbages as well, so that's a win. Again, I don't see anything wrong with this. Why was it cast off? It was cast off because it's surplus. Again, surplus veg, this would have gone to waste. It's perfectly good, it's a lovely size. It's really fresh. I don't get it, you know. Why would this go to waste otherwise? Then I'm not gonna grab all of these out of the box because there's loads of them, but lastly, we've got some nice potatoes. Small potatoes, about new potato size. These are from like the Suffolk, Norfolk, or Cambridgeshire or Kent area, so they could be from a number of places. But again, these are surplus. And to be honest, I don't think you can have too many potatoes. I mean, you know, they're always being sold in supermarkets. There's loads of these. There's probably, well, there's that many, you can see. And a couple more onions as well by the looks of things. Again, there's absolutely nothing wrong with those and they will be super handy. You can use those for pretty much, I'd say pretty much anything, but they're really versatile. Don't see anything wrong with those. And that's a pretty good box, if you ask me. There's some really nice stuff in there. So that's a pretty good amount of fruit and veg for 12 quid. That probably amount to about the same at the supermarket, maybe a bit more. But that's a nice variety. There's some really good stuff in there. So hopefully I can make use of this and make something out of it. I'll have to see what I can come up with. I mean, I've got loads of potatoes now. I've got plenty of mushrooms. I'm wondering if I can do something with those. Otherwise, I'll have to have a think on it. I won't do anything tonight because, to be honest, I've already had my dinner. I will be making something for the sake of it. Tomorrow I will be making something using stuff from this. If you are interested in getting a odd box as well, you have to be in like the Brighton or the London area. You can go check out their site. There's probably discount codes out there as well for getting your first order as well. This is not sponsored, by the way. I've just done this off my own back, but I'm just saying this because you might be interested in it. Basically, you set a day that you want things to be delivered, and generally they'll be delivered overnight. So you've got to kind of have like a safe spot for them to put the box because they do their deliveries overnight to cut down on emissions or something like that, but it's a nice green eco-friendly reason for doing so. So I think I can probably make some nice stuff out of this. I'm gonna go off, have a think. I'm gonna sleep on it. I'll come back tomorrow. It won't be tomorrow for you. Hopefully you will stick around and keep watching this and we can see what I can come up with my odd box. So it's now the next day for me, not for you, unless you are watching this video in two parts, in which case, good day to you. So after having some time to think on it, I thought with my odd box of vegetables, I will be making a vegetable curry because there's a nice mishmash of vegetables in that box. They will be perfect for a vegetable curry. I've got mushrooms, onions, potatoes, peppers. They will all go fantastically into a curry. I don't know why I'm doing this so much, but it's working. I'm emphasizing my point. Sorry. So this will be a bit of a random curry because I'm going to be using bits and pieces that I've already got in the flat. So if it seems a bit random, it is, but it will be a lovely curry. I've already done a load of boring chopping, so you don't have to see me do that. And I'm going to start off by making a curry paste, my own curry paste. And I'm going to do that by using some of the little onions that I've got, some peppers that my mum gave me. These are cayenne peppers. That's what they look like if you've never seen what a real one looks like in non-pounded form. I've got some ginger here, and I've also got a whole bulb of garlic here because quite frankly, there may be such a thing as too much garlic, but I haven't come across that much yet. So a whole bulb of garlic as well is going to go into my curry paste. So I'm going to put this into my little chopper here, or some other phrasing. I'm just going to blitz this up into a nice paste. Right, that is now a lovely, vibrant green paste, thanks to those chilies. I'm not going to do any real measurements or stuff on this because I am making it up as I go along, but feel free to try and replicate this. So with my paste nice and ready, I'm now going to get started with the actual cooking part because I've already done my prep work. Right, to start off my curry, I'm going to get a nice base of onions here. These are all the rest of the little onions that I had, which I've sliced up into nice strips. And I'm just going to cook these in about 6 tablespoons of sunflower oil for about 5 or 6 minutes, I think, just until they get some nice color onto them. Not too much, I don't want them to become bitter. I'm just going to keep moving them around. I've yet to make a curry on the channel, so this is kind of a first for the channel, but it's not any specific kind of curry. I'm not going to say it's like a masala or like a korma or anything like that. I am just making this one up as I go along. It's got a lot of the base curry flavors in it, but I wouldn't say it's any particular type of curry. Right, these have had about 5 minutes. They're just starting to brown, so that's a good point for me to now chuck in my curry paste. So I want to cook out some of this rawness from this curry paste first. Oh, I've just got a big hit of just all those flavors in there. I've got that ginger, I've got that garlic, I've got those chilies. It is an amazing smell. Oh, I just love cooking curry. Just get such an amazing smell going throughout the entire flat. And you really just want to cook a curry in stages and just cook out some of the really raw flavors. Otherwise you just get a really raw, overpowering flavor of all of these things. Sorry, I've just got a big hit of those chilies. Woo! Oh man. So now I'm going to add in some of my dry spices. So I'm going to go with a teaspoon's worth of chili powder, hot chili powder, because I prefer my curries hot. Teaspoon of garam masala, teaspoon of ground coriander, teaspoon of ground cumin, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric, and 1/4 teaspoon of asafoetida. And I'm just going to mix those in with everything else, really get those spices into there. And again, I need to cook these off for a couple minutes just because you get a really, again, big lung full of that. So yeah, you've got to cook out all that raw, really harshness out of these spices before you can carry on. So from my odd box, I'm adding in my wonky red peppers, then in go my perfectly good mushrooms. You'll notice I've taken the stalks out of these and peeled them. That's just because I generally find that they end up a bit slimy sometimes if you leave the skins on, but it's up to you. Then this isn't from my odd box, but I love them anyway. I'm going to put in some courgettes into there as well, or zucchini, as you might call them in the USA. I like to bulk this up with a load of nice veg because I'm not really adding anything else in. I'm not adding any meat. I'm not adding any tofu. It's a pure vegetable curry. We are celebrating vegetables with this curry. Right, I'm just going to cook those for a minute or two before I go on to the next stage. I just want to get a bit of colour onto that veg. At this stage, I'm going to add in my liquids and I will kind of deglaze that pan off a bit. Try and get some of those spices and things that I've cooked onto the bottom. So I'm just going to add in a little bit of vegetable stock here. Try and get some of those nicely cooked off spices from the bottom of that pan. And then in goes the rest of my vegetable stock. There's about 250 mils there. Then I'm adding in a tin of chopped tomatoes as well. Let's get that in there. Combine that in. And I'm also going to add in a tin of coconut milk as well, just to give it a nice bit of richness and a bit of creaminess. And also it will take a bit of that harshness away from all that spices. Mix that all through, all together. Now with that all brought up to a nice gentle simmer, I'm going to pop on the lid and then I'm just going to leave that to simmer away with the lid on for probably about a good 20 to 25 minutes. Just let all that cook together, get some really nice flavor in there. Oh, almost forgot. I meant to add in some bay leaves into there as well. Some nice home dried bay leaves. They'll add some lovely flavor as well. Okay, our curry has been bubbling away for a good 20 minutes or so. Everything smells amazing in here now. And now I'm going to add in my potatoes here, my potatoes from my odd box. I've just cut them in half, left the skins on, keep plenty of the flavour and the nutrients in those. Stir those through and bring that back up to a nice simmer. Now I'm just going to let that simmer and bubble away again for about 20 to 25 minutes again, but without the lid on, so the potatoes can cook through nicely, but also that sauce can simmer, bubble away, bubble down and thicken. How many times can I say bubble? One more time apparently. So I'm just going to let this cook away now, and I will come back in about 20 to 25 minutes to see how much this has reduced down. Right, a further 25 minutes later and this sauce has thickened up really nicely. It's lovely and thick. You can run a spoon through it. It doesn't fill in too quickly. That is about right. I don't want it too thick. I don't want to be able to chew my sauce, but also I didn't want it too thin, so it's like soup. So that looks really nice. And that is ready. That is now ready to eat. So I'm going to get this served up. Right, I've got myself a nice bowl with some lime and coriander rice. And yes, it is microwavable rice. Don't at me. Nothing wrong with rice that you cook in the microwave. Generally, it ends up better sometimes than the stuff you can cook on the stove because it doesn't come out so sticky. But I digress. That's going to go really nicely with my curry. So I'm going to serve up some of this into here. Should be enough for two nights worth here. Right, my mouth is actually watering. It smells so good. So there's nothing else left to do except get this in my face. So there we go, one lovely vegetable curry made predominantly from the vegetables from our odd box, or my odd box rather, and it smells fantastic. This just goes to show one thing that you could potentially do with vegetables that were supposedly not any good for the supermarket. Absolutely no idea why. All of those vegetables were absolutely great. I'm sure they're going to taste absolutely great in this curry as well. It's ridiculous to think that before we kind of had this awareness about this food wastage that was going on, about how much food was going to waste just being thrown out just because it's the wrong shape or size or anything like that. It's absolutely insane. I think I'm going to give this a try just to see how it tastes. I'm sure it's going to taste fantastic because it's really good quality veg and loads of lovely spices as well. So I'm going to give it a go. I'm going to take a bit of mushroom and probably a bit of potato as well and get a nice bit of sauce as well. Don't know how spicy this is going to be. I kind of eyeballed it, you know, didn't really measure anything out too much. Oh, well, it's certainly hot in temperature and it's got a nice kick of spice to it. Just like, just enough heat there, I think. I think I gauged that about right. Oh yeah, a little bit of heat coming through afterwards. That'd be those couple of chilies I put in there, plus the chili powder as well. Oh, that's really nice. That's got a really nice flavor to it. But those vegetables are really good. There's absolutely nothing wrong with those at all. When you think about that, these would have probably gone back into landfill or something like that, would have just gone to waste, not been eaten. You know, for the sheer reason that they're the wrong shape or size or anything like that. It's absolutely insane. Especially when you consider there's other countries out there that go without food and would love food like this. Yeah, it's absolutely criminal. So this is why things like Oddbox are brilliant, because it's making use of stuff like this. So if you're interested in Oddbox, then go check them out, because they are delivering now to the Brighton Hove area if that's where you live, or London if that's where you live. But there's got to be other places out there if you don't live in those areas, you know, throughout the UK. Go online, do a bit of research, try and find out, you know, what's in your area, or just go to your supermarkets now and see what they've got, because Morrison's are now doing their wonky veg, I know that much. I think Tesco are doing something similar as well, so go check those out as well. But if you are like worried about things like this, if you are worried about the planet in general, trying to make good use of our resources and trying to be, you know, a bit more eco-friendly and things like that, not throwing away stuff that we don't need to, then go and just do a bit of research, check it out, find out what's out there. But I've done enough talking, I'm sure you agree. I want to go off and finish this off because it smells amazing. It does taste really good as well. So I am going to head off. I'm going to go and finish this off. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, then let me know. If you want to see more things like this, let me know. I'll stick a link below to Oddbox so you can go check them out. Like I said, I'm not sponsored. I'm just doing this off my own back because I think it's an interesting thing to do. But otherwise, I hope you enjoyed it. I will see you next time on Big Friendly Grub. Take care. Bye. So here I've got myself a nice bowl with some lime and coriander rice, and yes, it is microwave rice. So here I've got myself a nice bowl with some lime and coriander rice, and yes, it is microwavable rice. Rice. I can talk. There's nothing wrong with microwavable rice. Well, apart from being able to say it, apparently. Oh dear.